Citizenship is the right to have rights. So it is the most fundamental of all rights. And we're talking about laws and procedures by which some people will have the right to have rights and some people will be deprived of them. And when we do this, we would expect our leaders to do this with integrity, with transparency and with compassion.
सिर्फ प्रधानमंत्री ने कहा था डिटेंशन सेंटर्स को लेकर और आज के अखबार में डिटेंशन सेंटर के फोटो तक आ गए हैं तो ये डिटेंशन सेंटर्स कहाँ कहाँ बनेंगे
कहीं नहीं बने एक बना हुआ है आसाम के अंदर और सालों से कोई डिटेंशन सेंटर फंक्शनल नहीं है और ना मोदी सरकार आने के बाद बनाए गए
आई हैव बीन इनसाइड द डिटेंशन सेंटर्स इन असम देयर आर एट लीस्ट 10 डिटेंशन सेंटर्स इन असम And 10 more are being constructed. They are much larger in capacity. And they're frightening stories of those detention centers where we are told that they're building even playgrounds and schools inside the detention centers. I don't know what that means. Are you expecting people to live, you know, whole families to live their lifetimes, or years and years in these detention centers? Amit Shah himself has instructed all state governments to construct a detention center. So that's absolutely a brazen lie. If I have to imagine hell on earth, this would be the kind of place I would imagine. Because it's hard enough to be in a jail, but this is a jail inside a jail. They have no hope of ever getting out. And this violates a whole range of national, international, constitutional and international law.
किसी को डिटेंशन सेंटर में नहीं रखा ये अफवाह फैलाई जा रही है स्मिता जी आज आसाम के अंदर जो 19 लाख लोग एनआरसी में नहीं आए थे उनको डिटेंशन सेंटर में नहीं रखा है अपने घर में ही रह रहे हैं
ये जो डिटेंशन सेल है एक किस्म का सॉफ्ट जेल है आप कह रहे हैं
सॉफ्ट जेल भी नहीं कर सकते उसको रखने की व्यवस्था
द मोस्ट डिस्टर्बिंग थिंग अबाउट द डिटेंशन सेंटर इज द इंडेफिनिट नेचर ऑफ द डिटेंशन बिकॉज प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड दीज आर नॉट मोस्ट ऑफ देम आर नॉट एक्चुअली फॉरेनर्स दे आर इंडियंस हु वर नॉट एबल टू प्रोड्यूस डॉक्यूमेंट्स सो व्हेन मिस्टर अमित शाह सेज दे आरंट एनी डिटेंशन एंड वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू सेंड एनीवन टू एनी डिटेंशन सेंटर इट्स अ डबल लाइ
I went inside the detention center with Harsh Mander as a researcher under a mission of National Human Rights Commission. We found that even those people, those actual foreigners, very small in number, they are dying to go back to their country. I found a foreign national with a small piece of paper. In that paper, he has written a phone number. For 6 years, he has been changing the paper. When the paper gets torn, he writes the phone number in another paper with the hope that one day he will get out of detention center and call this number in his home country.
And the numbers of people actually officially reported, I think about 3 or 4 who have ever been repatriated after all of this. Because they are actual Bangladeshis who, and that also through a very complicated procedure, the envoy comes from the High Commission and confirms. So these people are basically Indians who have not been able to present documents and who are locked up indefinitely.
If you are in jail, if you are a convicted criminal, you have certain rights, you have certain privileges. You have right to get parole after certain amount of time. You have right to work and get remuneration. But when you are in detention center, you don't have the right to get parole, you don't have the right to work and get remuneration, you don't have right to get bail, and you don't know for how long you will have to be in the detention camp. How does the people experience the detention center? I will tell you one story. Story of one lady. She spent more than 10 years in detention center. Yes, more than 10 years. Another lady, she was 4 years in the detention center. And when her husband died, the villagers went to the border police, requested the police to allow her to come and see her husband for the last time. But the police didn't allow.
पैनिक सिचुएशन शुरू हो जाता है जब डिटेंशन सेंटर की फोटोग्राफ्स निकल आते हैं कि एक ओपन जेल किस्म का बन रहा है।
मैं आपको बताता हूं, ये कंटिन्यूअस प्रोसेस है, इसका एनआरसी एक्सरसाइज से कोई लेन देन नहीं है।
टू प्रिपेयर द एनआरसी यू विल फर्स्ट डू अ नेशनल पॉपुलेशन रजिस्टर, देन दे से दैट बेस्ड ऑन द नेशनल पॉपुलेशन रजिस्टर द एग्जीक्यूटिव विल डिसाइड हु आर डाउटफुल सिटीजंस अमंग देम. And they will then be asked to prove their citizenship. And then you have the CAA behind all of this, where the CAA basically reassures people of any religious identity except Muslim that we have made a way, pathway for you. So if you aren't able to give your documents, you can still be given citizenship this pathway. But for Muslims, we have no pathway left. The purpose is really to reduce the Indian Muslim to remain continuously in fear and panic about whether they will be able to be a legal citizen of this country.